A 17-year-old girl surviving a shark attack off the Gulf Coast of northwestern Florida last week. Addison Bethea was scalloping in shallow waters when a large shark bit her multiple times. She bravely tried to fight it off, but the shark wouldn't let up. Fortunately, her brother Rhett, who is a firefighter EMT, was nearby. He jumped in, he fought the shark off, and he got her to safety. Joining us now is Addison and her brother Rhett, and they're joining us from Tallahassee Memorial Healthcare, where Addison is being treated. Addison, it is amazing to see you doing well. I know you have a long recovery battle and an operation, I believe, tomorrow ahead of you. Can you just tell us about what happened?
So I was in the water scalloping, and next thing I knew, a shark just come up at me and started attacking me. And I didn't really know exactly what to do, but I knew that with sharks, you're supposed to punch them in the nose to get them off of you, and I couldn't get around to punch it in the nose. So then I just started socking it in the face, and then I poked its eyes, and then I tried to latch it off of me with my fingers, and then it bit my hand. And I screamed for help, and then my brother came and saved me.
So, Rhett, you realized then she was in deep trouble, right, when you saw the blood?
Correct, yeah.
And so tell us what you did, because you and your life-saving skills are the reason why we're able to be speaking with your sister today.
Well, we were actually swimming side by side when it happened, and I heard her like make a noise, like almost like something scared her, and I sat up and looked and didn't see her, and then she came up from the water, and I saw the shark and the blood and all that, and then I swam over there and got him off, and then there was another boat that pulled up like right next to us to get her, so he helped me load her in the boat, and then we put the tourniquet on her and then got her back to the land as fast as possible.
And the tourniquet was the key, right, to stem the blood loss?
Right, exactly, because she's losing a lot of blood.
And Addison, you've already been through so much just in order to preserve some of your vascular ability in your leg, but we understand you have an operation tomorrow. Can you tell us about that and what is ahead for you?
Tomorrow they're supposed to amputate down into my knee, I believe so.
Just above your knee?
Above my knee, so it makes me easy. It's going to make it a lot easier in the end, so I'm excited for it, to be honest.
You're excited because you'll be more functional and able to do activities?
Yes, 100%. I'm tired of sitting in bed all the time.
Yeah, I mean, Addison, you're doing amazingly well. What do you attribute that to?
Honestly, just having family and friends around helps a lot, and faith in God, to be honest.
And your faith in God. And I see you have stuffed sharks around you. I see you have little stuffed sharks. So is this, you have a sense of humor? Are you not blaming the shark? Tell us about this.
I mean, everyone who knows me knows I take humor into everything, so, yeah, I just like stuffed sharks. I think it's funny.
And you think
it's in the situation, I guess.
You're making a little light of the situation. I mean, Rhett, what do you think watching your sister go through this?
I mean, it's definitely not something I ever expected to watch, but seeing her now and how positive she is good to see.
Addison, what have you said to your brother? I mean, his quick thinking is amazing.
He's always been kind of like a hero to me. Ever since we were little, he's always been there. And I don't really expect anything less of him, to be honest. Like, I knew once I was in trouble, he would get me out. He promised me, so I expect nothing less.
We thank God he was there with you, right?
100%, yeah.
Right, it's thank goodness that you were there right alongside of her and able to help her to get her to where she was able to get the help she needed at the hospital. What's ahead for your family, Rhett? And do you expect that you guys will be back out near and around the ocean anytime soon?
I mean, most likely. Addison seems like she wants to go back in the water, so that really just depends on her.
You're not afraid, Addison?
I mean, a shark's always been there. It just so happened to attack me that day, but I mean, I lived 17 years without a shark attack, so I'm fine with going back.
Well, I just thank you both for sharing your amazing story with us. And I do also want to draw attention for our viewers who are, I'm sure, inspired just listening to this amazing story. I know you have a GoFundMe fundraiser. Obviously, there are a lot of needs that go along with what you're going through, and this is to help you and your family through this road to recovery. It's titled Medical Expenses for Addison Bethea Shark Attack. So if you see that one, you can know that that is the real thing. Rhett and Addison, thank you so much. We wish you so much luck tomorrow during this operation and during your recovery, Addison. Thank you to you both.
Thank you.